And now, please give the warmest possible welcome to today's star organist, the fantastically talented Cameron Lloyd.
Amazing things to start off there. The first tune was called On the Prom Prom Promenade. That's my adopted signature tune these days, since we've been working in the Empress Ballroom in Blackpool, where the organist was Horace Finch. So that was his signature tune. And then, of course, we had those magnificent men in their flying machines there. Right, we're going to go over to three tunes in contrasting styles then next. So we're going to have Never on Sunday, a lovely old waltz tune then called Dancing with Tears in My Eyes, and then an evergreen called Chinatown. So here we go, three tunes in contrasting style.
Thank you.
And from three tunes in contrasting styles, we go to a little tribute to my musical hero. You might be able to detect a little bit of a Blackpool sort of sound coming from the instrument today. And my hero was Reginald Dixon. Some of you may know the name still. Reg was 40 years organist at the Tower Ballroom in Blackpool. And of course, Strictly Come Dancing comes from there once a year. Unfortunately, they don't use the Wurlitzer. I've never understood why, but if anybody's watching on YouTube, you know, use the Wurlitzer, use the Wurlitzer. But we're going to have a little tribute now, because on his very last LP, it was recorded at the Thursford Collection in Norfolk in 1980, by which time he was about 74, 75 years old. And there were three tunes that he played on that, and it's Good Night at Vienna, at the Café Continental, and Tell Me I'm Forgiven for Falling in Love. So here we go, the first one of these, Good Night at Vienna.
Thank you.
Right, we're going to stay in the sort of Blackpool sort of style next with a rhythm medley. So we've got one or two numbers here. We've got Sweet Sue, If You Knew Susie, Ma, He's Making Eyes at Me, Pair to Your Face with Sunshine, and Yes Sir, That's My Baby.
Thank you.
So after that rhythm medley there, we had a lovely old tune called Lagolandrina, which is, of course, The Swallow. Right, I'm going to play a waltz now. Those of you that have ever been to Blackpool Tower, some of you watching at home may well have done. And we're going to have Around the World. We might have something a little bit special with this. We'll see what happens. So here we go, Around the World.
case you haven't noticed, we've changed organists. I'm not him. Jacob, once he knew what was coming. Well, listen to tunes already. Dancing with Tears in Your Eyes in Chinatown, just splendid. Thank you for the comments. I'm reading the screen, by the way. I'm not losing my mind, in case you're right, well, anyway. Hello. I've come up with a bit of a problem. And the problem is this. When you play a dual concert with somebody, that's fine because you get to do half the work. It's great. The problem is that I said, Karen said to me, what are you playing? I said, well, I don't know. Whatever you play, I won't. So I made a list. And the problem is that he's played everything that I was going to. That is what remains. Absolutely nothing left. So it's all improvised from now on. So anything could happen. I'm getting the excuses out of the way now, so you can't blame me later. So let's start with a rhythm selection. I know one has already happened this afternoon, but we'll see what comes out. So here we go, and we'll start with, who knows?
Thank you.
I'm joking, I made a second list. And I kept it hidden. Moving right along now, we're going to move, we're going to slow things down a bit and hear some of the organ's more quieter tones. One of my favourite films growing up, original Charlie and the Chocolate Factory, I'm sure some of you, if not most of you, have seen it. And of course, the piece in that was Pure Imagination. And apparently, Gene didn't want to sing it because he thought he wasn't a singer, he was going to ruin it. Thank heaven he did not. Because of course it's an iconic piece and has been for years. So here we go, this is Pure Imagination, completely off the cuff, as usual, and here we go.
Thank you.
Mate, I tell you something. I need to invest in a tablet or something. Right, I was going to do... Is it gone? Over the side. Right, I was going to do a selection of television themes. Starting with a couple you know of them, you might not have heard them played on a theatre organ. We're going to start with Red Dwarf, the theme tune from Red Dwarf, and the theme tune from Star Trek. Before we go on to Meet the Gang, You Rang My Lord, Dad's Army, Blackadder, and who knows what else, so here we go.
Thank you.
now be a shortened audience here in our concert hall, Museum's Cafe is open, serving a variety of snacks, ice cream, alcohol, and soft drinks. And for the viewers at home and watching online, there's plenty of time for a cup of tea. So please go and enjoy. We'll be back right after the break. And now, ladies and gentlemen, please welcome back Cameron Lloyd.
To start us off there, welcome back to the second session. We're going to have one or two tunes from the 50s now. So we've got Who's Sorry Now, Diana, Why Must I Be Alone, Wandering Eyes, and Love Letters in the Sand. So here we go, the first one of these, Who's Sorry Now?
Thank you.
off my last little bit this afternoon. We're going to go back into the Tower Ballroom, or any ballroom of your choice around the country, and we're going to have one or two ballroom favourites. I'm sure I won't need to tell you all of these, but amongst them is it true what they say about Dixie? Nobody's sweetheart now, tuk tuk tuxie, once in a while, Amapola, forever and ever, Spanish eyes. It's quite a lengthy little bit, this. So before we welcome Alec Walters back on, here we go, into the ballroom.
Thank you.
well, it's time for me to say goodbye for this afternoon, so I hope you've enjoyed my little bit. We're going to welcome back Alec Walters. We're going to do the changeover up here this time so you can see what we did. Fingers crossed we'll hit a few more right notes than what we did last time. So, oh, hang on. What's what? I think I've played everything he was going to play. Oops. I don't know. No, we haven't. So we haven't rehearsed this tune, so it's Fascination, so it's bye-bye from me for now, and time to welcome Alec Walters.
That's how not to do it. That's how it's done. Sorry, you almost got it right. It's a lot more difficult than it looks, I tell you. Right, we'll move straight along now. I do actually have some stuff prepared, so don't worry about that. It's just a little joke, because why not? I must say a big thank you to the museum for inviting us down to do this. Like I say, we're doing it unpaid today because we want to try and raise some funds for the museum. So all of you watching, if you'd like to donate or anything, please do so. So, moving on, I'm going to do a ballroom selection now, because why not? And he's left me some stuff left to play, so we shall do that. Also, I'd like to say a welcome, I believe he's sat somewhere. Damon, where are you? Hello, Damon's up there. He's a bit like myself and Cameron, looks after the organs or whatever. He's also gone one step further because he's got a theatre organ in his house. Literally with the pipes and everything. So he's an absolute complete madman. But we do it because we love it, don't we? So there we go. So let's move along with the ballroom selection, starting with a popular tango called Jealousy.
Thank you.
Well, I'll have to play one more for you. Well, a couple more, if you've got the time. We shall do that. Right, one of my favourite organists when I was growing up was a chap called Sidney Torch. For those who haven't heard Sidney Torch, he was the resident organist at the Regal Cinema Marble Arch. His signature tune was Round the Marble Arch, believe it or not. Now, the organ at the Regal Cinema Marble Arch was a Christie organ. And when I say it was massive, it was massive. This organ, for example, is what we know as 12 ranks, as in there's 12 different individual sets of pipes. Regal Cinema Marble Arch was 36 ranks. And not only that, because it was a Christie, and it was their flagship instrument, they threw everything they could at it. It had tuned bird whistles. It had sleigh bells, marimbas, pianos, all sorts. And, got to get the number right, a 44-bell carillon. Full-size church bells played from the console. It was so loud that an injunction was filed against them and they couldn't use it. The organ still exists. It's in storage somewhere, and I would love to see it installed somewhere, who knows. But when I say the console, you look at the console, it was enormous. It sort of stretched around like that. You played it like that. You know. The poor lady in the front row thought I was going to dive in then, I was all right. We're going to finish off with a Sidney Torch version of a piece I always finish off with 12 String Rag. And this is, first of all, Sidney Torch's version, and then we'll spice it up a bit to end the show. So have you enjoyed yourselves this afternoon? Yes? Anyway. Good, we're glad. Have you all been to the museum? No? Make sure you go down there and have a look at some point. It's quite incredible. Although I've got a bone to pick with the museum, if you don't mind. Because in a display cabinet, in a museum, is an iPod 6th generation, right? And that makes me feel old, and I'm 28. Because I remember the original iPod coming, oh, crikey. I remember my mum used to still have cassette tapes in the car. In fact, my grandfather had an 8-track in the car, which was just unbelievable. David Bowie 8-track, non-stop all the way to Morecambe and back. Anyway, let's, here we go. This is Sidney Torch, 12 String Rag. Thank you.
Today's concert has been made possible thanks to the kind support of our patrons. Please consider helping us by joining them on patreon.com/musicalmuseum. Your support could make a real difference. Thank you.